Welcome back to Let's Play Mass Effect Andromeda. Blind, I am the RPG chick. We are finally going to leave the system. System view. I'm trying to move my mouse to click on that and, you know, we're not in that. Okay, so I guess these globes means that we have explored the area because we really have explored everything. A little jerky now with moving around. Oh, it seems better. So, cluster map. Cool. You are here. As if the little ship icon wasn't enough. So we got Pfeiffer system. This is obviously the main quest. But let's go to the Pfeiffer system first. Now the game does say I'm 11% done. From 10. I'm not sure if that's because I went up to level, I gained a level up to level 4, or because I completed that station saboteur mission, or a combination of both. Interesting though. 1% more. Cipher, oh. I'm used to just clicking on it. Now I have to use the action or interact button. Whatever you have that mapped to. Cool. I like that.
This is about as far as the Nexus surveyors could get before. Let's see what's waiting here. Anomaly on sensors.
Cool. Anomalies. I like anomalies. Well, let's...
Deploying probe.
Now we can deploy probes from here, but it doesn't seem to do anything now, does it? It is a black hole. Look at that. We could kind of see that from the other system where the Nexus is. That's cool. I definitely want to check that out. But first, H480. I guess we haven't named all these planets yet. I'd say this is all very well... Oh, I like that. Right through that. Oh, it's awesome. This is my favorite part of the game so far. Just doing this, just watching, taking it all in. Oh, I love it. Okay, so this is a planet. Thick dust clouds, dangerous electrical storms, and heavy gravity render H480 inhospitable, even for well-equipped Krogan explorers. Activate scanner. Really just... I guess you do scan it. There's just nothing here. What was that? Was that just a storm? I saw a flash of some... Oh, that's just a storm there. Cool. Alright. Now if I hit T for exit... It brings you all the way out, got it. That's why I thought it did. But anyway, I guess there's nothing here, or I haven't scanned it like I should. Because in the planet view, we just... I'm guessing these flashes of these rectangles in the circle here don't really mean anything. I was wondering about that. So system view.
I'm picking up something.
Okay, so I guess we do have to scan this from...
Probes launched.
And I'm guessing we don't run out of probes. Okay, Corvath.
Probes launched. Anomaly on sensors.
So an anomaly is this way, it's basically telling me. Oh, Anomaly located.
Deploying probe. Tracking a huge mineral deposit.
Cool. Cool. Check that out. Love this. This particle. Particles and asteroids. Cool. It's a lovely jarring stop though, isn't it? It's a C-type asteroid. Very low gravity, of course, because it's an asteroid. The unusual mineral composition of this asteroid suggests that it may have origins outside the Pfeiffer system and became caught in the sun's gravity. Plus 86 aluminum. Cool. Done. Kind of weird moving this around. I feel like I'm almost in the program of the... You know, if you guys ever see, you know, programs that they use to, like, render and create, you know, objects like this, it looks to me like I'm in that program. Whatever program or programs that is. Okay, so we found that. Korvath. We can't scan that one. Wait, I think we go like this. Nope. Is it because we... It's so weird, it doesn't do that now. I guess we're all scanned out? I don't know. Alright, well let's go there then. Now departing asteroid with aluminum on it. Cool. I like it. Thanks to Korvath's thin atmosphere, its brutally cold deserts can reach extremely high temperatures in direct sunlight. Limit exploration to twilight hours only. Well, I don't think we're going to be exploring anything here. Okay. Can't seem to scan. Or send a probe, rather. Activate scanner. Ryer, whatever. Am I out of probes or something? Because I don't know. I can't seem to send them anymore. Because I don't see any kind of numerical status on how many probes we have. So I figured we have unlimited probes. Though the planet is highly toxic to most known life forms, Ryer's helium-rich atmosphere appears to host enormous colonies of fungal spores. Oh, goody. Progression 57%. H461. See, now we get this. Hope this isn't too boring for you guys to watch. I actually love the animation. It's really well done. Really puts me into it, you know. I feel like... I don't know, it's awesome. This outlying world is composed of iron and frozen nitrogen. One oddity stands out. Certain geological features suggest the nitrogen seas were once liquid. So, what I am noticing is that the planet descriptions are a lot shorter, at least so far, than the trilogy. No atmospheric pressure. So we still got this planet, H479. I'm trying to activate scanner every time when I get this, so... I can almost imagine these particles hitting the hull and making little tech 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 sounds. Extreme radioactivity and high velocity winds make H479 a poor candidate for mining, despite its rich metal deposits. A potential candidate for future endeavors. Progression 85%. I haven't looked here though. Or have I? No. I don't think so. H461. This is a very pretty planet. Close but no cigar though. Oh, I've been, that's why it shows up without us zooming in. So that's a discovery point, so we've already been here, obviously. So we gotta check out this black hole. Be dangerous, isn't it? We're gonna die now. Yeah, impress me with this. Watch out for that, what do they call it? The event horizon? That's pretty freaking awesome, though. I mean, never before have we come across a black hole. Well, actually, no, we did. At the end of Mass Effect 2, there was a black hole in the center. But it's nothing that we can just, like, scan. Class Care Black Hole? H-012 Ketos. Even at this distance, the black hole presents a risk to onboard ship systems. The accretion disk around it is composed of the remains of at least one solar system destroyed by the black hole's formation and gravitational pull. Caution is advised. We're done with the system. That is one system. Of course, we don't have an option of even going closer to it. Kind of curious, you know. Alright, ladies and gentlemen, that's the Pfeiffer system. Complete. At least for now. Cluster map. Continuing on to the Eriksson system. No, there's nothing else here, right? Yeah, we've got local stuff. Eriksson, and this is the main quest, obviously Pytheas. And we go like... Zoom in now. Okay. To the Eriksson system we go. So obviously there's no planets we can land on back in that other system. So we're really human. After all.
Heck of a wake-up call.
This is where he came from. This is where Habitat 7 is. Finland, Helluland, Habitat 7. I wonder if we can land back on that planet.
Probes launched.
So there's a probe, there's a thing that way. Now, I don't want to land. I wonder if we would, though. There's no reason for us to go back on it, at least not that I know of. Well, does it pose a danger, this crap? I mean, obviously, in general, it poses a danger, but...
Anomaly detected.
On the planet? I wonder if it poses a danger just in, you know, looking through the system like we're going to be doing now. So it's an anomaly back on where we were. So what we thought we could settle this planet, but I guess the Scourge messed it up. Average surface temperature is 17 Celsius fluctuating. That's pretty cold. Atmospheric pressure is higher than normal. That's because of the Scourge. Orbital period, 31 years. Wow. So they have long day and night cycle. Right? Or would that be seasons? Even visual scans show that Habitat 7 is no longer a promising settlement world. Whee! The planet's atmosphere is largely argon nitrogen, and little of the protected plant life has survived. I wonder how it survives with, argon nitrogen.
Probes launched. Satellite detected.
Oh, a satellite. Power reading 6.4%. Okay, it's running out of power. Internal circuitry damaged by Scourge exposure. Currently inactive but salvageable. A standard monitoring satellite. Its registration shows it was deployed accidentally from the Hyperion during its collision with the Scourge. Okay. Gained 50 Milky Way research data. That's cool. My mouse is going off the pad here. Okay. Cool, cool.
Anomaly detected.
Indeed. Let's check out the first planet, Vinland.
Sensors.
Vinland is a small rocky world with a pressure cooker atmosphere composed of argon and carbon dioxide. Its valuable cobalt deposits would require robotic mining due to volatile surface gases.
Probes launched.
What you got for me?
We've got a crater.
We've got the crater. Hypervelocity impact crater. Ejecta silicates, mineral deposits, trace amounts of element zero. A crater caused by the impact of heavy debris, possibly from the Scourge. The meteorite still contains valuable resources. Alright, such as experience. And I guess that's it. I didn't get any resources here. I know what you're talking about. Alright. I guess it's nothing quantifiable as far as in game terms or whatever. Next.
Detected.
We're 5% done with scanning planets. So we got another anomaly. These two are... What do you call it? See, no, not necessarily. They all have this kind of globe sphere around them. So it doesn't necessarily mean we discovered them yet, because these have it. Helluland. Helluland. So I'm not sure, the sphere maybe represents the planet's atmosphere?
I'm picking up something.
Or it makes it easier to see, either one. So I like this feature. Very familiar. To ones who played the first three games. Or two, rather. Two and three, I meant. Named for the first landing of the human explorer Leif Eriksson. Awesome. Helluland's crust is largely composed of aluminum with sulfur deposits brought to the surface via volcanic activity. So maybe this is a volcano again.
Deploying probe. Tracking a huge mineral deposit.
What's a mineral deposit? Aluminum. A valuable light metal. The deposit is close to the surface and relatively easy to mine. Plus 108 of that. Okay. We're almost done.
I'm picking up something.
You sure are. So I've explored, yeah, everything except for this one, apparently. Markland. Not Marklar. Markland. Okay, so there's nothing on this one. So there's another anomaly, I think. Markland is a large frozen world with a surface composed composed mostly of silica with deposits of cobalt. The planet's albedo is unexpectedly dark, suggesting geological activity or contamination from the scourge. Okay.
I'm picking up something.
We're still picking up something. I thought there was something else, but we're 100% done. Wait, we've got something. Why does it say 100% done?
Probes launched. Anomaly found.
Starship wreckage. It shouldn't say 100% if we still have something to find. I'm gonna have to keep that in mind. Who knows, we might have missed something in one of those two other systems. Oh wow. Oh yeah, that's messed up by the Scourge right there.
That's the research vessel. Dr. Aridano informed us of.
Oh good.
There are no life readings within.
Well, not good, but...
She'll want to know.
At least we found it. Ship identification, Nexus 33-12. Ship name is Uduxus. Kind of like Exodus, only messed up. Switched around with a extra U thrown in there. Crew complement was 7. Status reported missing, presumed lost. The Uduxus sustained pervasive damage due to scourge flares that wiped out all internal systems. Dr. Aridana's crew was killed instantly. Vessel adrift, unsalvageable due to radiation. Well, at least they had a quick death, right? Really enjoying this part of the game so far. Gain 50 remnant research data. Well, we've salvaged something. So it was unsalvageable. So we completed a quest. Wow. That's pretty cool. Now, we could go back to her, but I don't want to just go all the way back to the Nexus just for that one little thing. So, let's continue on to Pytheas for a better beginning. So reminds me of Doctor Who, the intro.
System, Pytheas. Andromeda Initiative Habitat 1. Designated EOS.
Okay, Pytheas.
It was supposed to be an easy first step. Until no one else showed and we got clobbered. Twice.
Why has Sam altered frequency detection?
What are we hearing, Sam?
There is a signal pathfinder. I recommend an immediate examination of EOS.
Well, I am not going to examine it immediately. I'm going to check out these other planets. Let's check Khonsu first.
Probes launched.
Let's look at this first, actually. Then we'll go to Khonsu.
Probe away. Tracking a huge mineral deposit.
Let's grab it. It's like it was still outside the system, looking in. That be it. An M-type asteroid. An iron-nickel-rich asteroid. Its dust indicates the same scourge contamination that affects Eos. Plus 98 iron. Okay. Khonsu, right? We're gonna start from the outside and work our way inwards. I hear that boop! You know that sounds so much from the, I think it's from 2 and 3. Boop! You can hear it in the background. Like they just threw that in.
Anomaly detected.
Okay. So, it's very cold here. Khonsu's oddly mild climate, given its orbital distance and rich resources, make it a candidate for a mining outpost. However, its unexpectedly rugged terrain has tabled discussions indefinitely. Yeah, we don't need to be discussing that. Let's just check this out.
Probe away. Tracking a huge mineral deposit.
Cool. Beryllium. A metal ideal for lightweight construction in a variety of applications. This deposit is readily accessible. Then we shall access. Plus 81 beryllium. Cool. This will help with like research and stuff like that. And or development. I forget which one, you know, does which. Okay, so we will work our way to the second planet here. Well, second planet from the outside anyway. Nanook. See, we don't have an option at all. I guess because there's nothing on it. Hear that?
Yeah.
Boop. So it's not main part of the game, not when you select something, but they just play it in the background with the other noise of, you know, departure kind of thing. I like that. I do like it. Just that it's there. Nanook is a hydrogen methane gas giant. Debris in its orbit suggests it has seen Ket visitors. Okay, third is this one. H276. No probe option.
Picking up something.
Oh. We do have something on this. So we can scan it remotely, but we can scan it here. Interesting the way things change, I don't know. It's very high, a lot of atmospheric pressure on this planet. Remote and cold, H276 is nevertheless of interest due to phosgene gas in its thick chlorine atmosphere. This could indicate primitive chlorine-based life. However, no detailed study has been completed. Of course not, because we've been busy trying to stop ourselves from getting blown up by people who are pissed off.
Probes launched. Satellite detected.
We got a satellite. Okay, it's the Nexus 0900-G. Power readings at 84%. Still's got a lot of power to it. Data links prepped for download, status operational. Huh. A scientific monitoring satellite launched by early explorers to Eos. Its mission was abandoned when the original settlement of Eos failed, but has gathered valuable data from H276. Isn't that where we just came from? Alright. 50 Milky Way research data. Alright. House of research. H276. Kansu Pele. Okay, I am there. Okay. So I figured we found data on this planet. Let's see. That's where the satellite is. So I figured we found data, but so maybe something else would be uncovered, but apparently not. Alright. Okay, so the next one is this guy, Pele. That sound. I guess if we turn music off, we could really hear it well. I don't know if you guys can hear it. This happens like a second or two after I, you know, leave that planet, we start moving away. It's a very hot world. 7.01 atmospheres. Surface temperature 781 Celsius. Yeah, it's a little hot down there. Tidal heating and bombardment from Pytheas' asteroid belt has aggravated Pele's volcanic activity. The methane in its upper atmosphere contributes to the planet's scorching conditions. Okay. Pretty awesome. You would survive about a second and a half down there. That's my professional evaluation. 1 second and a half. So Eos is next, but we're going to skip to H060. H060, was it? I'm surprised. Only 188 Celsius. Only 23.65 atmospheres. Hey. H060 and its satellites attract debris from Pytheas' asteroid belt, resulting in multiple dust rings. Numerous meteorite impacts have left H060 rich in nickel, but these same impacts make mining difficult. Just gotta be difficult. ~87% done. So as far as I can tell, this is our last... Sometimes there's things outside the system that we can look at, but doesn't appear to be the case. here. You can move far out. That's very interesting. Dun, 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 dun. Alright, let's head towards it. We're not gonna land this episode. At least I don't think so. Unless we unexpectedly land right now. I'm guessing we'll have the option to land.
A mirror of the signal on Habitat 7. Possible atmospheric manipulation.
Hmm. Is that possible?
We'll find out. If it is like Habitat 7, no doubt we'll run into the Ked.
Okay, so we have viability levels for this. Valuable minerals are listed there. I guess that's aluminum. Fe is iron. V would be vanadium, right? C, not sure. Oh, we also have the... We have three quests here. The Lost Brother, right? We have to place the medal or whatever the hell it is, pendant, on his... where he died. And the first murderer, get evidence about that murder of his friend. So we're 100% done with the Pytheas system. A desert world with significant resources, Eos is often racked by deadly radiation-contaminated storms. Great. More of that stuff. Catalogued as non-viable after numerous attempts to settle. Signal detected. Similar to the devices on Habitat 7. Signal... where? Oh, well, then decide. Okay. If I... okay, that just lands, obviously. Okay. I'm gonna stop here. And we will land there next episode. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you in the next one. And endure. And enduring, grow strong.